full house audience, or at least, which basically means that you've got 90% or more people to see your film. Mommy. So congratulations.
Can you say that again?
One more time for you.
Cosplayer Nation will be getting a laurel that says achievement unlocked. You have gotten an audience of 90% or more to see your film, so you're getting a full house laurel. Thank you.
I watched the first Tenchi Muyo movie without really knowing what the heck it was. I just sat there and just said, whoa, this is interesting.
When Bug Mama was about second or third grade, my friends and I, we would put on little Persian cat, or little black cat ears, and we'd run around with some of your Persians.
My movie would play some of a really neat anime popular in the beginning. But of course that's illegal, but there's no one to really get them. So like, the anime viewers just have like two girls and we'll say on silly group legs.
I found out that like one of these two ones and a couple of other really big anime conventions in Minnesota were extremely popular, and there was this whole crew of people who would spend their entire year prepping for the next convention.
And we went to the convention thinking that it was mandatory for you to dress up in costume or you wouldn't get into the convention.
I kind of thought people were really weird, to be honest, but then I saw some really good ones and I was like, oh my god.
I was like, I'm gonna have to go to dance. So got myself an Emma Frost costume and got myself over here to San Diego at the comic convention.
I mean, most people think it's just an anime thing, but if you look around at all the people around here, there's video games and Star Wars.
I would say that it does transfer into cosplay territory when you're doing a particular zombie from a certain movie. Like, this is a Dawn of the Dead zombie, this is, you know, Walking Dead zombie, things like that.
And I just want to cosplay as Santa because she was like
zombie. Yo,
follow them too, and they have fan pages, and they do have YouTube, and it's kind of, we have like a small little community of Gaga lookalikes, and, you know, have dress up and make their own little web series.
Are we part of this documentary? Yeah, we're cosplaying jet setters. Well, I appreciate anybody dressing up as our characters, because it makes it kind of weird in my head. When they're mildly sexualized, I like even more. But when I see actual people dressed up like henchmen, I think they're real. You know what I mean? Because they would go to a con. Like, all the henchmen would go to a con. Yeah, go to a con. You might as well wear a outfit. Why not? It's real. Yeah.
I'm like, the word is scary.
Going to Seinfeld. Mr. T was like Superman to me. What I loved about the series was the camaraderie. You know, you got four brothers in arms, basically running from the law, but helping people out when they can, putting their own needs aside, but doing what they can to help people that need their help, if you can find them. That's what I'm talking about.
Common sense, really. I mean, people have always liked to dress up. You know, you look at Venice Carnival, you think of Mardi Gras in New Orleans. And I said, you had these something called tableau vivant in the 19th century where people would act out kind of scenes and like in a picture wearing kimono.